this video, we are going to look at the formulas of differentiation, which we are going to use in polar curves. Let's take a formula number one. D by dx of number is equal to 0. Differentiation of any number equal to 0. Let's take an example. D by dx of minus 7 is equal to 0. Minus 7 is a number. Differentiation of that is equal to 0. Next formula. D by dx of x is equal to 1. Differentiation of x with respect to x is 1. Let's take an example. D by dx of 7x is equal to 7. Whenever we see number in a differentiation, take that number outside. So if we take 7 outside, differentiation of x is 1. Let's take another next formula. D by dx of x power 5 is equal to 5 into x power 4. See, in this kind of a power differentiation, when you see x power something, the number which is in the power of x will come from x power, that number will be reduced by 1. So if you take d by dx of x power n, m will come from x power, the power should be reduced by 1, so n minus 1. Next, d by dx of sin x is equal to cos x. D by dx of cos x is equal to minus sin x. We'll look at the next set of the formulas. This set, it's actually a rule. We call it as a chain rule. Let's take an example to understand this rule better. D by dx log of cos of x square plus 2x plus 3. Let's solve this question. See, first layer we can see log differentiation is 1 by x. In place of x, there is a cos of x square plus 2x. So log x differentiation is 1 by x. In the form of x, there is cos x square plus 2x plus 3. Now we have differentiated log. Now we'll go to the cos. Cos differentiation is minus sine. In place of x, there is x square plus 2x plus 3 into. Now the cos is also differentiated. Now we'll go to the inside form, that is x square plus 2x plus 3. The differentiation of that is 2x plus 2. It's basically a chain rule. What exactly chain rule is? We have to differentiate one by one from outside to inside of the function. Example 2, d by dx of cos 3x. Let's try this out. D by dx of cos differentiation is minus sine. In place of x, there is a 3x. Let's substitute 3x into. Differentiation of 3x is 3. We can write this as minus 3 sine 3x. Try to solve this question. D by dx of sine of cos of 3x. Now we'll go look at the next set of the formulas what we need to understand. The next set of, again, it's a kind of a rule, that is change in variable. We'll call it as a change in variable. See, when we differentiated x with respect to x, that was dx by dx, we got the value of 1. Now, let's try to differentiate y with respect to x. That is dy by dx. So, if we differentiate z with respect to x, we'll get dz by dx. Now, if we differentiate r with respect to theta, we'll get dr by d theta. Let's look into some of the example where we can apply this. Let's take an example. D by dx of y square. Let's look into this. See, when you look at the y square, we have to think it as x square and we have to try to differentiate. If it was x square, the answer was 2x, so y square, 2y will be an answer. Again, now we have to know what is the differentiation of y. Y differentiation is dy by dx with respect to x. Next, we will take another example. D by dx of z square. Now, again, we have to think in terms of x. So, if it was x square, we will get x 2x. Now, we have z square. Now, we have to get 2z into differentiation of z with respect to x is dz by dx. We'll take another example. D by dx of r square So now the differentiation of this will become 2r. The r differentiation is dr by d theta.